Howdy folks, I'm Part Time, and you're watching Part Time's Tips and Tricks to Fast Draw.
All right, so you're gonna need basically three tools to do this. Set of pliers, screwdriver, and something to pin the spring with. Here we go. First thing you wanna do is take off the grips. That's a stock Ruger spring. Now what I'm gonna do is show you how to cut the spring so you don't have to put a lighter gauge aftermarket spring in. Some people prefer the lighter gauge. I like to cut the original spring. I feel like the thicker spring has a little more snap. It's a little less spongy. Alright. I'm going to take the trigger springs loose on each side. This is going to be a little bit difficult because this factory spring is super tight. Gonna wedge that up. Just like that. It's like pulling a tooth.
Ow! Oh!
Now, this is a very important step right here. You want to take a towel or a rag. And you want to cover it up. If you don't, this little piece right here will be somewhere in the living room. Hold that, pull the pin. See how much tension that spring had on it? Now, I recommend not to cut more than 5 coils off of this spring on a brand new gun. Once your gun is a little more broke in, you can go back and cut another coil off. But if you cut too much, you'll get light strikes on your primers, which will cause misfire.
Misfire.
Now, I have already got a cut spring. And this is how much I cut off of the spring that I'm gonna put in there. This is a pretty broken gun. I can get away with that. But like I said, I would recommend you cut somewhere along here starting out. Something else I do on my Rugers, I like to use a small split washer. Sometimes I'll use 2, 3, whatever it takes. Get the hammer striking the primers correctly. Now this spring washer is not going to be even like that when you first get it. It's going to be kind of offset. You want to twist it with a pair of pliers and make it even. When you put the spring on, you want to put the cut in towards the washer or towards the top of this rod. That way the factory end will set flush against the clip. Then you slide that on. What I like to do is take my pliers, shove that down, get a bite on it. Drop that in place and put the pin through, boom, just like that. That's ready to go back in your gun. Goes back. While we're doing this, let me show you something else. Some people like to change out the trigger spring to a lighter trigger spring. You don't have to do that. You can take this trigger spring and put a slight bend upwards on it. See, this side's already got a little bend to it. That slight little bit of bend on each one of those springs is the equivalent of a lighter trigger spring. So you don't have to buy an extra trigger spring. Now, of course, the reason you shorten the hammer spring is to lighten the hammer pull. Most people believe that putting in a lighter trigger spring, it makes it easier to pull the trigger. The truth is, when you react to the light and jerk this gun out, pulling the trigger is going to be the easiest part of fast draw. You're going to pull the trigger. The real reason for lightening the trigger spring is inside here on the hammer, it's got a rounded front that rests on the trigger. And the more tension the trigger spring puts against the trigger, the more it pushes against the hammer. So you're actually lightening the trigger spring to lighten the hammer pull, not to lighten the pull of the trigger. You're gonna place that back in there like that. You see it kind of slide up into a little notch there. Just the same way we took it out, drive it back in place, pull the hammer back, take the pin out, rehook the trigger springs,
tricks to fast draw. Don't forget to subscribe and be sure and hit that like button. The quicker, the better.